Jake Gyllenhaal needs to watch this video because he's going to need some book recommendations since he's not going to be able to leave his house for quite some time. Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Avery from A Very Avid Reader, and welcome back to my channel. For those of you who have never been here before, what's up? Thanks for joining. Thanks for coming along on this journey, on this ride. So something very important happened to me this past week. Maybe it happened to a few of you as well. But Taylor Swift released Red, Taylor's Version. And did it change my life and cause an emotional awakening within me? Maybe. Am I okay? I don't know. But I'm thinking that I want to take this beautiful work of art and turn it into some content I can do here on BookTube. So I feel like I've talked about it a little bit before here, but I'm just a huge Swiftie, and so I just thought it would be fun to take her new release and turn it into a book tag here on YouTube. So I decided to create the Red Taylor's Version book tag slash challenge. Basically, the way it works is I took a bunch of songs from the album and I like kind of put them into categories, and so you'll pick a book that has to do with each song on the album. And I didn't do every single song because it's like 30 songs long and that would just be a really long video. And not all of the categories are like correspond with what the song is about, because let's be honest, it's a heartbreak album. It would just be 30 books that are sad. And like, I'm good. Don't really want to put that much sad content out there. So you'll see once I get started, but each kind of category is themed off of the song or like the title of the song. That's pretty much it. Before we get started, comment what your favorite song is off of Red Taylor's Version. For me, I think it's either The Very First Night. I really love that song, but I also really love Better Man, Taylor's Version. And I had heard the original version with Little Big Town, but I don't know why. Taylor's version is just hitting different for me. Let me know in the comments what your favorite song is off the album, or multiple songs. I know it's hard to pick one. Oh, also I have to say, like, I loved the 10-minute version of All Too Well also, but I feel like that's a given. It's so good. If you want to create this video, please do. I'm not really gonna tag people because I just want anyone who likes the concept to make the video. So if you want, definitely make this video. That would be awesome. I'd love to see it. Comment below and tell me if you do, and I'll definitely check out your video. So the first question goes with Red, and it's, what's your favorite Red book? So a book that is actually physically read. For this one, I don't have it with me here, but I chose Queen of Air and Darkness by Cassandra Clare. And this is the third and final book in the Dark Artifices series by Cassandra Clare. If you've never read these books, definitely you wouldn't start there. You would need to start with like whole rest of the series and eventually get up to Queen of Air and Darkness. But just in general, I love the Shadowhunters books. They're so good. I feel like everyone knows what they are. If you don't know what they are about these half angel, half humans called Shadowhunters, and they protect the human world from demons. And there are multiple different series within like this one world. So if you haven't checked them out, then definitely start with the Mortal Instruments series. But I love it. And the cover is so pretty. Like, so pretty. The next question goes with I Knew You Were Trouble. And for this one, I want you to pick out a book that you knew you probably wouldn't like, but you still read it anyway, and then you were right. Like, you just knew that you wouldn't like it, and you didn't like it. For this one, I chose 1984 by George Orwell, and I know that this is like a hot take, but I didn't even finish it. I could not get into this book. I didn't find the concept intriguing. I just thought it was boring. I really tried to read it because I know it's a very popular book, but I was just bored. Like, I was bored. I didn't think the writing was special. I don't know. Maybe one day I'll pick it up again. Probably not. But I don't know. I wasn't a fan. I started it and I was like, And I kind of knew going into it, like, it wasn't a premise that I thought was interesting. So I kind of knew that I probably wouldn't like it, and then I didn't. The next question goes with All Too Well. So for this one, pick a book that you know all too well because you have read it so many times. And I'll be honest, yes, I am making these questions, but I actually couldn't think of anything for this category. I really like this question because I know there are people who like read the same books over and over, like their favorites, and I have favorite books, but I really cannot think of the last time that I reread a book that I loved. I feel like I just always want to read new books that reading an old book doesn't feel like a waste of time. Obviously, it's not a waste of time if you love it. But I just kind of don't want to reread right now. I just want to read new stuff. So I couldn't even think of an answer for this question. But if you have a book that you just love, you feel like you go back to it all the time, and you know it all too well, then hit it up. The next question goes with I almost do, and for this one, I want you to pick a book that you almost pick up all the time, but you just never do, or something that's been on your TBR forever, and you just still haven't gotten to it. You don't know why, you almost do, but you just read something else. For me, this book is The Song of Achilles. I've heard such great things about this book. My mom has read this book and told me to read it, and I have like gotten it on my e-reader. I use Libby, and so I've gotten it like lent to me multiple times, but for some reason, it always expires and I never read it. I just always get caught up reading something else before I can actually get to it. And then like my hold expires on it and it goes away and I have to wait weeks for it again. And then I put in another request and then I'm reading something else and I just haven't gotten to that book yet, but I've been trying to read it for like months. It is on my TBR. I'm going to try to read it soon. The next question is, we are never ever getting back together. So what is a book that you hated and you will never read again, you'll never recommend it to anyone, that kind of thing. This book I didn't hate, that's a strong word, but I just will never read it again. I probably won't recommend it to anyone. And it's The Appeal by Janice Hallett. I read this recently and it has a really cool premise. It's a murder mystery, but the format of the book is in like emails. So you're just reading a bunch of emails and a few texts between a bunch of these characters trying to figure out like what happened. So I really liked that idea of it, but it was just, it's a large book, and I just felt like there were so many like dumb emails that you were reading. I don't know, it just felt like filler, and it just took forever to just get to the juice. You're just reading emails and like you're getting suspicious of people, but nothing really happened until like the last third of the book. And so that's just kind of why it was a little just like slow paced. That's it. I think I only gave it like 3 stars. It's just kind of like, eh, not gonna read it again, not gonna recommend it to anyone. It just exists. The next song we have is Sad, Beautiful, Tragic, which is a very underrated song. I love that song. It's so good. So this one is just kind of goes with the theme is pick a sad, beautiful, tragic book that you love, but it is just very sad. And for me, I chose The Sorrows of Young Werther by Goethe. I read this over the summer, actually for a class that I was taking, and I really enjoyed it. I also want to say that this book does deal with suicide, so if that is something that you don't feel comfortable reading, then definitely don't read The Sorrows of Young Werther. This book follows a young man named Werther who falls in love with this woman, but she is engaged to somebody else, and he becomes good friends with him and her fiancé, but he's so in love with her and he struggles with mental health issues. And this really is one of like the first books that has had a character with mental health issues, and it was kind of like a novel thing at the time when it came out. It's really sad, beautiful, tragic. The writing is so beautiful and like Werther's like plight is so like tragic, but it's still like beautiful at the same time. I don't know why, but it's a very beautiful book and it's sad, but I would recommend it if you're kind of like wanting to be in your feels. It's also like a classic novel, but it's like very easy to read and it's not that long either. Next up we have Everything Has Changed featuring Mr. Ed Sheeran. And for this book, I want you to pick a book that either changed you or changed your taste in reading. So for this one, I chose Mistborn by Brandon Sanderson because this changed my taste in reading because it was really like my first fantasy book that I've ever read and I really loved it. And so now I feel like I've been opened up to that genre and it's something that I like really want to explore. If you want to know my full thoughts about this book, I made a whole review of it, so you can definitely check that out. But I definitely plan on reading the rest of the series, and I never thought that fantasy would be something that I was into, but this changed me and realized that, hey, maybe you actually do like it. Next up we have Begin Again, which is also one of my favorite songs off of Red, and I really like the re-recorded version of it. I feel like it sounds better than the original. It has some more harmonies in it that I just love. Plus, the music video for that song is out of this world. I love that music video, the vibes are just immaculate. You know what I'm talking about if you've seen that music video. So good. But for Begin Again, choose a book that you want to reread or start over. So for this one, I chose Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte. I started this a few months ago and I got a few chapters in. Let's see, this is where I got 3 chapters in and I just didn't pick it up again. I was very bored by it. I know it gets good. Like, I know that. I know it's a good book. But whatever state of mind I was in, I just didn't feel like rereading it, or I didn't feel like continuing it. So I do want to reread it and start it over and really just give it my all. But if you've read this book and like you felt that way at the beginning, comment some encouraging words of wisdom for me, because I don't have much of a desire to pick it up, but I know it's good. I know that. So I need to read it. I need to reread it. I need to begin again, you could say. The next song is Ronin, and for Ronin, I want you to pick a book that you loved as a kid. I think I've talked about this in my BookTube newbie tag all those months ago when I first started my channel, but I loved the Warriors Cats series, okay? Those books went hard, and if you weren't a cat kid, then like, that's probably a good thing. But I love the Warriors Cats books, and then I also really loved the Gregor the Overlander series. My mom actually read those to us as children, and that series was dope. So both of those are just great kids' books, and loved them. Those were kind of what sparked my love for reading, I think. Okay, so now we're getting into the vault tracks. So the first one that I have is Nothing New, featuring Phoebe Bridgers. And I don't know if this is an unpopular opinion, you can fight me about it if you want in the comments, but I wasn't a huge fan of this song. It wasn't like my favorite song. I couldn't relate to it that much because I'm not like an artist in the music industry, so I felt like it was a little unrelatable for most people, but it was pretty. Like, their voices sound good together. Like, I'm a big Phoebe fan and a big Taylor fan, but it was anything special for me. But if it was for you, then that's great. Don't kill me. That's just my thoughts. But for Nothing New, I want you to pick a book that is older that you have read recently and really liked. So picking a book that's nothing new. I get it. Anyway. For this one, I chose Persuasion by Jane Austen. I love this book. She's obviously not new. I really liked Anne Elliot as a protagonist, especially since she's a lot different than other Jane Austen heroines, in that she's like very shy, very easily persuaded, and it kind of takes her a while to like buck up and like do what she wants. But I thought that was like interesting to read about. It's different from other Jane Austen books that I've read. And also Captain Wentworth, great character. The ending of this book is it's one of the most like romantic declarations of love that I think Jane Austen, that I've read so far. So I love Persuasion. The next song that we have is I Bet You Think About Me, featuring Chris Stapleton. And I like this song. It wasn't like my favorite vault track, but I liked it. And I think there's some really good lyrics in there. So for this one, I want you to pick a book that you think about often, or that after you finished reading it, you just like, your mind is blown and you just thought about a lot, or if you continue to think about it. So for me, continuing the Jane Austen streak, I have Pride and Prejudice. This book, I consistently think about. Something will happen in my life and like a line from this book will pop into my head that happened to me a few weeks ago. And I was like, I'm such a nerd. Like, why is a line from Darcy like popping into my head right now? But it did. I'm sure everyone has books like these where something happens in your life and then you like think about a character in that book, or you think about a line from that book. So think about one that you think about a lot. That was a lot of thinking. The next song is Forever Winter. And for this one, I want you to pick a book that deals with mental health that you really love or think does a good job depicting mental health. And you might be like, why for this song? I didn't realize at first. I just thought that Forever Winter was like a song about not knowing like what's going on with your partner and, you know, wanting to be there for them. I saw on Twitter that the song came out around the time, or she wrote it around the time that Taylor's friend died of an overdose when he was like 21, and I think he also dealt with like mental health struggles. So re-listen to Forever Winter and think about it from that perspective, as just being a friend who's there for a friend, and it just makes a lot more sense. And so that's the way that I am interpreting it. I think you could also interpret it like as a relationship, a romantic relationship, or just even a friendship. For this one, I'm going to recycle one that I've already talked about, but The Sorrows of Young Werther. It's not known, you know, what mental health issues that Werther had, but a lot of people think bipolar disorder or depression. I just think it was a great, Goethe did a great job getting into the mind of him, and you really feel for him throughout the whole book, and you don't think that he's crazy. You just, like, feel for him, and I think that's, like, the best kind of depiction of mental health is when you can just really empathize with the character. And so I think that is why this is my pick for that. Next up we have Run featuring Ed Sheeran. I also really like this track. I think it's really pretty. I think Ed Sheeran and Taylor Swift's voices blend together beautifully and they always sound really good together. So for this one, if you were going to run away and could only take one book with you, what would it be? So for this, I chose Strange the Dreamer by Lainey Taylor. Ooh, it's reflecting. I love this book. I've talked about it so many times on my channel, but I read it earlier this year and everything about it is beautiful. The prose is beautiful. She's such a good writer. The characters are like so compelling. You just like love them and want them to be happy. It has a little bit of everything. It has fantasy aspects of it. It has romance. It has great world building. And this series is so good. If you haven't read Strange the Dreamer, read it. You have to, or I'll... But it follows a boy named Laszlo Strange, who has always been obsessed with this lost city of Weep. And basically, Weep, it's like a lost city, and no one has ever been there and come back. And one day, Laszlo gets the opportunity to go, and Weep has this big problem that they're dealing with. And so Laszlo gets there and he's tasked with helping them solve this big problem, which is a mystery. You find out later what it is. He also starts dreaming about this girl, and it's in Weep that he, you know, maybe meets her, maybe realizes what she has to do with this big problem plaguing this ancient city. Anyway, it's a great book. Read it. The next book is The Very First Night, which is one of my favorite Vault tracks. I just think it's so good. It's just like a pop anthem. I love the song. So for this one, pick a book that you read in one night or in one sitting. Get it like the very first night, like you read it on the very first night. So I've only ever done this twice, and most recently I did it with The Midnight Library by Matt Haig. And I read this on the flight home from studying abroad this summer in England. Because it's not like a super long book. The flight was like 9 hours, so I just sat there and read it. But I talked about it a little bit in my book haul from England, and it was not my favorite book. I thought it was very predictable. So I will say, as a trigger warning, the character does commit suicide at the beginning of the book, and so if that's not something you'd like to read about, definitely don't pick this up. But she basically goes into this library where she gets to go into different versions of her life if she had made like different choices, and she gets to stay in one if that's the one that she like wishes that her life had been. She gets to stay in it and just start over. So she goes to these different versions of her life, and then I won't spoil the ending, but it was very predictable. A third of the way in, I was like, I know how this is gonna end. I know how it's gonna end. So it was kind of like I was just reading to read, even though I really knew what was gonna happen. So I don't really love that. I don't love predictability, but also I know a lot of people really love this book. So maybe it was just me, just didn't strike a chord with me. But if the premise is something that you'd be interested in, then I say maybe try it. Okay, we have made it to the final question, and this song is the final track, All Too Well, the 10-minute version. I loved this song. I also really loved the short film with Dylan O'Brien and Sadie Sink. I thought it was so good. So obviously a 10-minute song is a long song. It's very long, but it's worth it. So for this book, I want you to pick a very long book that's one of your favorite books. I chose Chain of Iron by Cassandra Clare, which I read earlier this year. Really, you could pick any of Cassandra Clare's books that have come out recently. This book is like over 600 pages. So this series is also in the Shadowhunters world. So if you haven't read any Shadowhunters books, definitely start with The Mortal Instruments and read them all because they're all so good. Yeah, I can't really give too much away about this book without spoiling other ones, but I just love Cassandra Clare and everything that she ever does, ever. So, much like Taylor Swift. So that is it for my Red Taylor's Version book tag slash challenge. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video, and if you did, make sure to like and subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. Definitely make your own version of this if you enjoyed it. I would love to see what you pick, and this is my first time making my own tag, so let me know if you do it. I would love to see some people do it, especially if you're a Swiftie, obviously. Definitely comment down below what your favorite song was off of Red, Taylor's Version. And also comment if you've read any of the books that I mentioned and what your thoughts on them were. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I will see you in my next video. Hey Siri, play All Too Well.